And then, the third part of a minute hence, some to kill the cankers in the musk rose buds, some war with rear mice for their waxen wings to make my small elves' coats, and some keep back the nightly owl that clamours and hoots at our quaint spirits. Sing me now, sweet, then to your offices and let me rest.
What thou seest when thou dost wake, do it for thy true love take. Love and languish for his sake, be it ounce or cat or bear or pard or boar with bristling hair. In thy eye it shall appear, when thou wakest it is thy dear. Wake when some vile thing is near.
Faint with wandering in the wood. And to speak troth, I forgot our way. We'll rest us, Hermia, if you think it good, and tarry for the comfort of the day.
Be it so, Lysander. Mind you out of bed, for I upon his bank will rest my head.
One turf shall serve as pillow for us both. One heart, one bed, two bosoms and one trunk.
Nay, good Lysander, for my sake, my dear. My feather off yet, do not lie so near.
Take the sense sweet of my innocence. Love takes meaning in love's conference. I mean that my heart unto yours is set, so that one heart we can make of it. Two bosoms interchange with an oath, so then two bosoms and a single troth. So by thy side, no bedroom we deny, for lying so, Hermia, I do not lie.
Lysander riddles very prettily. Now much beshrew my manners and my pride at Hermia man to say Lysander lies. But gentle friend, for love and courtesy, my further off yet, in human modesty, such separation as may well be said becomes a virtuous bachelor indeed. So far you distant, and good night, sweet friend. They love near altar till their sweet life end.
Amen, amen, to that fair prayer say I. Then end life when I end loyalty. Here is my bed. Sleep, give me all his rest.
With half that wish, the wisher's eyes be pressed.
To the woods have I gone, but Athenian found I none. On whose eyes I might approve this flower's force in steering love. Nice and silence. Who's here? Weed of Athens, he doth wear. Oh,
this is he, my master said. Despise it, the Athenian maid.
Here lies the maiden sleeping sound on the dank and dirty ground. Pretty soul, she does not lie near this lack love, this kill courtesy. Churl, upon thy eyes I throw all the power this charm doth owe. And when thou wakest, let love forbid sleep his seat on thy eyelid. Wake now when I am gone, for I must to Oberon.
Say, though thou kill me, sweet Demetrius.
I charge thee hence and do not want me thus.
But then, darkling, leave me, do not so.
Stay on thy peril, I alone will go.
Oh, I am out of breath in this fond chase. The more my prayer, the lesser is my grace. Happy is Hermia wheresoe'er she lies, for she hath blessed and attractive eyes. How came her eyes so bright? Not with salt tears, if so my eyes are oftener washed than hers. No, no, I am as ugly as a bear, and beasts that meet me do run away for fear. Therefore no marvel that Demetrius do, as a monster, fly my presence thus. Oh, what wicked dissembling glass of mine made me compare with Hermia's fiery eye. Ah! Who's here? Lysander? On the ground dead? Or asleep? I see no blood in the wound. Lysander? If you live, good sir, awake!
Oh. I'm run through fire, but I for thy sweet sake. Transparent Helena, nature shows art that through thy bosom let me see thy heart. Where is Demetrius? Oh, how bitter word is that vile name to perish on my sword!
Do not say so, Lysander, say not so. What though he love your Hermia? Lord, what though, and yet Hermia still loves you. Let me content.
Content? With Hermia, no! I do repent the tedious minutes I have with her spent. Not Hermia, but Helena I love. Who would not change a raven for a dove? The will of man is by his reason swayed, and reason says you are the worthier maid. Figs growing are not ripe until their season, and I, being young till now, not ripe to reason. And touching now the point of human skill, reason becomes the marshal to my will, and leads me to your eyes, where I o'erlook love's stories written in love's richest book.
Wherefore is this keen mockery born? When it's your hand did I deserve this scorn? It's not enough. It's not enough, young man, that I did never, no, nor never can deserve a sweet look from Demetrius, I, but you must flout my insufficiency? Good truth, you do me wrong. Good sooth, you do in such disdainful manner me to woo. But fare you well, perforce, I must confess, I thought you a lord of more true gentleness. Oh, that a lady of one man refused of another be abused!
She sees not Hermia. Hermia, sleep thou there, and never mayst thou come Lysander near. For as a serpent of the sweetest things, the deepest loathing to the stomach brings. Or as the heresies that men do leave are hated most by those they did deceive. So thou, my serpent and my heresy, of all be hated, but the most of me. And all my powers address your love and might to honor Helen and be her knight.
Help me, Lysander, help me to thy best to pluck this crawling serpent from my breast. I mean, for pity, what a dream was here. Lysander, look how I do quake with fear. Methought a serpent did my heart away, and you sat smiling at his cruel prey. Lysander.
What? Removed?
Lysander, Lord!
Went out of hearing, then? No sound, no word.
Alack, where are you?
Speak, and if you hear. Speak of all loves I still no one's with for you. will perceive you are not mine. Either death or you I'll find immediately.